This is my updated Ultimate Thunder Cage build. This build cost me 12 crystallization catalysts. The main reason why I made this build is that I want to make an all-purpose weapon that can be used on any content in the game. In Season 1, we are now able to install multiple crystallization catalysts in a single socket. What this means is that we can now change or socket any modules that we want. I have two builds for two of the most important content in the game as of right now. So the first build is for Invasion. Invasion is all about how fast you can clear the obstacles in front of you. So I highly recommend modules that deal elemental damage and fast reload. The second build is for Void Intercept or boss fights. There's really not much difference, but I will explain it later. Let's start with the Invasion build or Infiltration Operations build. For the weapon readjustment stats, try to roll for firearm critical hit damage, firearm critical hit rate, firearm attack, and bonus firearm attack versus Colossus. You can also replace firearm critical hit rate or bonus firearm attack versus Colossus with weak point damage depending on your rolls. For the damage modules, action and reaction, and rifling reinforcement, increasing firearm attack by 78%. Next is the critical hit rate modules, edging shot, and better insight. The base critical hit rate of this weapon is 20%. Using the two modules increases the base critical hit rate from 20% to 36%. Now, it is highly recommended that you use a descendant that has abilities that can improve your critical hit rate, like for example, Balbi with a transcendent module called Supply Moisture, which adds a flat 20% critical hit rate to any weapon. This means if your weapon has a critical hit rate of 36%, it will add a flat 20%, totaling to a 56% critical hit rate. Next is the critical hit damage modules. Concentration priority and better concentration increases the firearm critical hit damage by 194%. The base critical hit damage of the weapon is 2 times. Adding the two modules increases it from 2 times to 5.896 times. And this is why I recommend using Valby, because this weapon is a very good crit weapon. Next is expand weapon charge, which increases the round per magazine from 26 bullets to 38. And fire rate up increases the fire rate by 25%. Second to the last module is I socketed a cerulean and a malachite. I socketed cerulean and used a recycling genius module because I want a very fast reload weapon. In invasion missions, you are going to run out of ammo in your magazine quickly because there's a lot of targets and objectives. For the last socket, I socketed a cerulean, almandine, suntic, and rutile. The reason is that I want to use elemental bullets or bullet enhancement depending on the mission. If I am up against Legion of Immortality, then I'm going to use toxic enhancement. If I am up against Order of Truth, then I will use electric enhancement. And for the Legion of Darkness, I will use chill enhancement. For the Void Intercept Battle or Boss Fight build, the only difference is that I replace Recycling Genius into Weak Point Sight. Weak Point Sight is very good for boss fights since weak spots of the boss are so big and easy to hit. Depending on the boss, I will use a bullet improvement depending on their elemental weakness. For example, Molten Fortress is weak to chill damage, then I will use chill enhancement. Or if I'm fighting Frostwalker or Gluttony, then I will use fire enhancement. Also, always check your bullet enhancement on your weapon before going into a Void Intercept battle or any mission. You guys are probably wondering why I'm not using Weak Point Sight on my first build, and the reason is actually pretty simple. It is really hard to hit weak points on the enemy unless it's a boss or if the target is really close. If I see an enemy, I usually just go and shoot in the general direction because it is easier. Mid to far targets are really hard to hit with headshots, that's why elemental damage is the best. Also, this SMG has an insane recoil. As for the reload module, this just speeds up the animation of the reload. Once the ammo is inserted, you can cancel the animation by rolling, grappling, or using your melee attack. This is actually pretty helpful as it saves you a small amount of time. Last but not the least, This weapon is going to have a lot of ammo issues since this weapon eats your ammo reserve pretty fast, especially in boss fights. To solve this issue, I will explain to you guys the ammo reserve trick. First, you need a general rounds weapon, and it could be anything, a handgun, SMG, assault rifles, or even machine guns. In my case, I'm using the last dagger since handguns have a very fast swap animation. Now, you need to use two modules, general rounds compulsive and expand general rounds. Every time you pick up a general round ammo, you are going to swap to the weapon that has these two modules to increase your total ammo reserve. To further increase the weapon swap animation, I use better weapon weight and a special module also called better weapon weight. With these two modules, weapon swapping will be incredibly fast, and every time you swap, you gain 111% increase in defense. Also, you don't need to level up all these modules to level 10, level 9 will suffice. I also use a module called normal special rounds refining. Every time I pick up a special rounds bullet type, it will convert it to general rounds. This module is really not needed, but if you can afford it, then you might as well use it. After picking up the general rounds ammo, do not forget to swap to the thunder cage, as this weapon will slow you down by 20%. With this build, you don't have to make another weapon if you want to. This weapon is more than enough to do all the content in the game. Thank you for watching and have a nice day. Exhilarating.